My dear students, we are now moving to the second part of this great chapter. In the second chapter, Mrs. MME Forestier shows different kind of jewelry to Matilda. Mrs. Loisel. What she shows, some bracelets, then a collar of pearls, then Vatican cross and different types of jewelry. But Matilda was not satisfied with any types of jewelry or the pearls or Vatican cross or the Venetian cross of gold and jewelry. She was looking, she cast her eyes on a diamond piece. That diamond piece was studded with different kind of diamonds. She put it against her breast and felt very irritated. She politely asked, apprehensively asked Mrs. MME Forestier, can you lend me this diamond jewel of yours? And she said yes. And she felt very overjoyed. She hugged her and went away with that piece of diamond. And in the party, in the ball, Matilda's beauty was a huge success. She was looking extremely beautiful with the dress of 400 francs and with the diamond jewelry. And every man followed her, asked her name. They wanted to spend the time with her. She was looking elegant, gracious and wonderful. She was dancing all night. She was full of enthusiasm, intoxicated in all the glory she had. She went home in the 4 in the night. And when she was searching for her husband was lying in, her husband was sleeping in a little saloon, there with 3 other men. The wives of 3 other men were also enjoying the party. And then they collected and went away. There is one very particular incident here. She does not want to reveal her identity to the rich woman. Why? Because the rich woman were covering themselves in the rich fur, fur of animals. But Matilda does not have such kind of a dress, so she went away, frisked away. And even her husband was calling her, wait, I will call the cab. But she descended the steps and reached somewhere where there was nothing. And they find nothing except a particular kind of a nothing except a coachman. And they went. This is the time when the Paris, there is a nightfall. After that, the Paris is seen. Then what happened? They took the cab, and in the cab, they barely reached the home. And Mr. Loisel has to remind himself at 10 o'clock, he has to go to the work. And at the final time, Matilda went to see her face in and dress in the mirror. When she was absolutely bewildered, she was stunned, she was aghast that there was no necklace, and she shrieked and called her husband immediately. And he was half undressed and he says, what happened? That I can't find MME Forestier necklace around my neck. And she said, what? Did you remember that when you were there dancing for the ball you have it, and when you came back from that you have it? She said yes. And then her husband told, if you have dropped on the street, it would have made the noise. Maybe it is in the cab. He immediately ran away and searched everywhere, this and that. And he came back at the 7 a.m. in the morning and found that the necklace was not there. Even Matilda was in the gown. At 10 o'clock, he does not have the strength to go to the bed. Now they were very, very anxious, angry, animated, agitated, and they were totally shattered. They were going hysterical, berserk. Then what happened? Mr. Loisel put the advertisement in the newspaper, told the police also, and for the reward also, but it was all in vain. They have not found the necklace. Then again they went to a particular place called Palace Royal. Palace Royal is a place where they found the diamond looking similar to that particular piece which his wife has lost, but that diamond was of whopping 36,000 francs. And it was of 40,000 francs, but you can buy it for 36,000 francs. And father of Mr. Loisel has left only 18,000 francs, and Loisel then took the loan, heavy loan, for looking 5 years old in such a small period because of the tension, overbearing, imposing, and so much tension. He was looking 5 years more old. It is written in the chapter. So 18,000 his father has left, and another 80,000 he has took from the money lenders, from the usurpers, and he make ruinous promises that he will return. And then he went back to that shop and he got it. When he got it, he in the meanwhile he told his wife that you should write to MME first year telling that you have broken the claps of that diamond necklace. And after that, he got that diamond necklace by paying whopping 36,000 francs. And when his wife went to MME Forestier for returning that diamond, MME Forestier, in a rigid tone, rigid means in a angry tone, told her that you should have returned this necklace to me a bit earlier. This is the part of the second part of this chapter. Now, at the final, we will go for the third part. Thank you.